In this particular mini video, I am going to talk about why do we really require a computer network, or what do we get from using a computer network, as well as a brief discussion about LAN and WAN. The first thing why you need a computer network is it permits you to share resources. Resources can be physical objects like printers, scanners, so on, or they can be software objects like programs, data, and so on. Networks also facilitate us to communicate with each other. For example, you have seen the Skype call, Google Talk, Google Class. These are all examples of communicating using a internet or communication network. Now, users can share information through a mechanism called as file sharing. For example, I could upload my video onto YouTube. That's an example of sharing my file with all you people to learn. Another example is, or a very common application of networks is something known as the client-server model. When you look at the word client and server, you understand that server is the boss and client is taking services from this particular server. Like I told you in the previous video, let us say I have got a huge program which uses a lot of data and takes 3 days on my machine to run. But the server, being a super high powerful machine, maybe could execute that program in half an hour. So what I could do is I could submit my program and data to the server. The server will execute the program with my data and send me back my result. So generally servers are very high powered machines, could be parallel computers or extremely high configuration computers. Clients could be your simple desktop, laptops, and even your mobile phone. Now, using the internet, we are able to write emails, read blogs, social media, all your Facebooks, Instagrams, and so on. Without the net, none of these would have been possible. So that's another reason why you are wanting the internet. Now, if you look at voice calls, most of you have not seen the old telephones. Basically, the old telephones used a different technology. Whereas through the internet, if I want to talk to you, I use a technology or I use a method of communication using the internet protocol, or known as the IP network. So using the IP, my voice is broken down into a number of small packets, and these packets are sent back between me and you. So that's the way we are able to communicate or talk with each other. Be able to run all these classes thanks to the internet. So education during COVID-19 is a good example of why we need a computer network. Imagine if there was no computer network, the only other medium would have probably been using televisions for learning. And sharing of hardware devices like printers, scanners. Suppose I have a very huge file, I'm getting say 2 terabytes of data. My laptop maybe has just half a TB of space. So then I can request for additional storage space on the computer networks. So I may borrow processor from somebody, I may take the storage network from somebody, and so on. So these are typically why we would need a computer network. Now the first network I'm going to talk about is something called as the local area network. So when you get into Graphicra and you're working in your lab, you'll invariably be working on this local area network. Such a network is generally owned and operated by a single organization. For example, Graphicra owns those internal local area networks. They are generally found in small offices, labs, it could be in a company or a university, and so on. A LAN could be across the entire university campus. So what a LAN really looks like is, you could have one or more of this, all interconnected and able to share information and resources across this network. This is the old-fashioned network called as the Ethernet. Nowadays we use switches to connect all of these particular machines. So local area networks are generally restricted to a single entity or a single organization, a small office, lab, building, or a university campus. Now, if you take all the local area networks and you end up connecting them, okay, somehow there's a way of connecting them. Don't worry about how they are connected. So such networks which are connected across wide geographical areas, or you can think of them consisting of millions of local area networks interconnected, this is an example of a wide area network. And the best example you can think of a wide area network is the internet, because internet is nothing but it's a connection of millions and billions of LANs, other devices like laptops and your mobile phones in a network. So what happens is, this is one LAN, this is one LAN, this is one LAN, and this is one LAN. So what we have is the means of talking to the other objects or other nodes in the networks is through the router. The router will be able to find out, okay, the gateway or the router is going to tell you how to communicate with the outside world and how to receive traffic and give it back to you. So the switch is used to communicate within the local machines, whereas the router connects you to the outside world. So wide area network, in simple words, it's a collection of multiple PCs, other networking devices, local area networks interconnected. A good example of that is the internet, so that we are able to talk to each other. So with this, we wind up our notes on or talk on networks, computer networks. I'm just going to provide you the lecture notes for four or five devices, like the network interface controller called as the NIC. What is the proxy server? What is the firewall? What is a modem? What is a router? Their diagrams, along with brief one or two lines. You're required to just read them and do a little bit self-discovery on your own, because I believe once you come to engineering, you should have that curiosity and ability to locate information and make an effort to understand things on your own. So that is a very first step to help you get a little curious and find out a little more about those four or five devices I have mentioned in my lecture notes along with this particular slide. All right, with that, let's say goodbye, and we shall meet in the next session discussing about something really, really interesting called as programming logic using algorithms. Until then, goodbye.